straight from Gujarat, Mr. Rajiv Kumar Gupta, the MD GNFC. Mr. Gupta, welcome to the show. My first question to you would be regarding the TDI chemical. What's the price outlook? How basically the volume growth is looking like, and what's the utilization right now?
Yes, Piyush, as far as TDI is concerned, I'd like to inform you that our plant has been running very well, and we have crossed over all the production targets, the budget that we make every year. There is a very good news on front of TDI that the anti-dumping duty, which was imposed provisionally by the Director General of Anti-Dumping, has been confirmed for next 5 years yesterday. From almost $120 to $400 plus on three countries, Japan, Korea, and China. So TDI anti-dumping duty has been confirmed. As far as physical exports are concerned, last month we crossed over highest ever target of physical exports of TDI, more than 3,000 tons of TDI we exported last month. Total turnover till November of TDI in rupee terms, in absolute rupee terms, has already crossed over by the end of November the total turnover achieved in the last financial year. So next 4 months, that is December, January, February, and March, would be additional turnover in rupee terms. From our domestic market share, we earlier used to give about 35-40% of domestic market. Now we are covering almost 60% of domestic market, and we hope to cover almost 70-75% by the end of this financial year. So TDI front, the company has been doing very well. But as I have repeatedly said, that this company should not be evaluated only on TDI. We make many other specialty chemicals. Acetic acid, we are the only producer in the country. Formic acid, we are largely the majority producer in the company, in the country. And ethyl acetate also. Now, all of these three chemicals have been running at highest ever price realization. So the company's real evaluation should be both by way of TDI and also by way of other specialty chemicals.
Fair point, Mr. Gupta. I wanted to ask you on formic acid and acetic acid, but TDI actually at present was in the limelight. But then since you have initiated around both the chemicals here, what I want to really understand is, because the stock price again is 4% up, and I want to relate from second quarter to third quarter, you were just highlighting that 8 months of volumes is now equivalent to the last year 12-month volumes here. So in terms of second quarter, third quarter, what has been the volume growth? And because the price levels are very high across acetic acid, formic acid, TDI chemicals, so how basically the margin trends are looking like? And also a bit of flavor, if you can give, the price level in third quarter versus second quarter.
Well, prices of TDI have been firm. Internationally also, the TDI prices have been ranging in the bandwidth of $4,200 to $4,500. And we already have about 3,000 tons worth of export orders pending for the current month and for part of the next month. So price trends and bookings, as far as TDI international market is concerned, is very firm, and the trend has been maintained from the second quarter to the third quarter. Other chemicals have already specified that they are also doing very well. And as far as fertilizer, I would like to say something about the fertilizer also, because your screen is showing us also as a fertilizer company. Now, fertilizer sales have also been very good, almost 10% higher as compared to the same period last year. And the stock position is very, very encouraging. We are almost having the one-fourth of stocks of fertilizers, all fertilizers put together, ammonium nitrate phosphate, and also urea, as compared to last year. Last year, we had in the same period about 200,000 tons plus stock of fertilizer. This year, we have just about 52,000 tons of stock of fertilizer. So fertilizer offtake has also been very good.
Then actually that tells me that if the volumes actually are so good, does that imply that there will be good sort of destocking, good sort of volume growth, and that could also imply operating leverage effect? So perhaps margin should be stronger in the third quarter versus second quarter, acknowledging, as you were just saying, that price levels in the third quarter basically for the chemical space is looking similar to second quarter. Can the margins actually increase?
See, implications I will have to leave to you to pronounce. I cannot pronounce on the implications because we haven't declared the quarter results so far.
Sure.
But the quarter has been so far good. But ultimately, you see, again, I would leave a word of caution here, that this is a company having almost 21 plants of different kinds. And constant running of those plants, maintenance, sudden shutdowns, all those things will have to be taken into account before I can really pronounce on the increase or decrease in margins.
So one question I want to ask you regarding the methanol blending, what we have heard is government's intention to actually go for 15% methanol blending. Very early days, takes time, but what it means for a company like you?
Well, methanol, we have about 900 tons of installed capacity, of which we have been using partly only because we use we need methanol for our acetic acid production. And to that extent, we have been producing daily. Sometimes the market is up. Yes, we have been producing additional methanol, and we have been selling it in the market, as we have been doing currently for the last almost 3-4 months, and we're getting good realizations on that. Now, for methanol, the basic input is gas or oil. And almost 70 to 80% of the variable cost of methanol is that. Now, unless the gas or oil is available at a low input cost, the mass production of methanol may not be so easy. And that is why most of, in fact, there are four companies in India which have methanol production capacity: Assam Petro, GNFC, GSFC, and there's one more company. But in most of these companies, except GNFC, there is no regular production of methanol. Assam Petro, I think, produces something around 100 tons per day. So for methanol production, somewhere down the line, the gas will have to be provided at some reasonable rates. And yes, we are open. We have almost 700 tons of additional methanol capacity, and if the government so decides, we will definitely put that to use.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Gupta.